You know, I can't figure out what to feel about this tech sell-off, because how much is it really a sell-off? Microsoft's market cap is still over $1 trillion. Yes, Apple's exactly off 10% from the high, but it's got all this China exposure. So is it really that bad?
No, John, I don't think it is. I mean, I think the market is showing you it wants to buy stocks, and it's being hit repeatedly with political issues and foreign policy issues that really justify deep concern. But the reality is there's a huge amount of cash on the sideline. Earnings remain good. And in this particular situation, I think the market is being rational. You know, it recognizes that the deal with China is a real thing, but it also recognizes that China has interest in trying to prevent this from going off a cliff. And the real uncertainty is in Washington, less than in Beijing. And so from my perspective, I think the market is being totally rational in looking to go back up here. And I think that's how investors should look at it. If we're going to get nailed
here, John,
if we're going to get nailed, it's going to come from somewhere unexpected.
So do you wait for that unexpected thing to happen? Do you trim certain positions? Do you go? I mean, it's interesting. You look at IAC and Match. Match had this amazing quarter, particularly with Tinder. People are dating out there. You know, it's up 20% last time I looked.
John, we're in 10 years into the bull market cycle. We're not looking at this as a 10-year opportunity from here. We're in the final stages of this thing. You know, we're as likely to have a melt up as a melt down. And so as a consequence, I think we're really in a trading situation where right now the fundamentals of equities are on balance really good for being long. And, you know, we're very late in the economic cycle, and we have this incredibly unpredictable, I guess you could call it a policy, coming out of Washington, which is really almost, it's very emotional and very almost like childlike in terms of the way it's about reacting and provoking. And the market is right to every once in a while let some air out of the balloon. But at the end of the day, we're playing the last stages of a market cycle. And I think you're supposed to remain long as you have confidence that you can get yourself out.
Roger, where specifically within equities do you see buying opportunities right now?
Well, I mean, everything's lower. And in my mind, I think Apple's strategy is going to work out. That over time, you're going to see them move the iPhone from a thing that costs $1,000 to something that you get in a subscription for $30, $50, $75 a month. I think Netflix, you know, having gotten banged around here, is worth taking a very serious look at. At the end of the day, they have a better technology base than any of the other streaming companies. More competition is obviously not a good thing. But I do think they're a winner at the back end of this thing, and that the market for streaming is going to go up at the expense of cable. And so I think that's a very good thing to look at. I think there are smaller names that I find really interesting. You know, companies like DocuSign that have built really a unique position in the marketplace, and that, you know, really are worth taking serious looks at. Not, they aren't cheap on conventional measures, but nonetheless, I think it's a really big winner in the long run. And to me, that's the kind of place to look at.
Where do you think the privacy debate, the regulatory and antitrust scrutiny debate goes from here when the president is occupied with escalating a trade war with China? Is there a connection there or not?
I have absolutely no idea. And, you know, I spend 7 days a week on the issues of dealing with internet platforms. And the thing that is really clear to me is that both Republicans and Democrats have spun up on antitrust. I think they feel it is time to encourage alternative business models to come into the marketplace. And that'll be fantastic for investors, because there are a lot of things that you can do with the next generation of AI and the current generation of ad tech that are not being done today, because they don't fit perfectly into the model of Google or Microsoft or Facebook. And in my mind, more antitrust, investors should embrace that. That's going to be a really good thing, but it's going to take a long time. To me, dealing with the actual underlying issues of people's public health and their the elections and privacy is going to take a different kind of government intervention, and we're super early on that. So I think the bet that Google and Facebook are making, which is that we'll either lose energy or just forget it, is probably, you know, right now, sadly, I feel that that's probably the more likely thing, although I think that would be a
tragedy. Yeah, it tends to be a decent bet.